This device here is another OCR device. This is called the OrCam Read. It's made by a company called OrCam. It is designed for people who want to be able to have material read to them out loud in anywhere they want to be. And it is designed specifically for use without internet. Everything it does in within its own memory and its own processing. So that way you don't have to have any connections at all to the internet. This right here, this right here is a Bluetooth speaker I brought just because the volume on this device is not really loud. I mean, it's loud enough, but it might not be heard on the video. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it on. This button here is the power button. Moving this way, this is the minus button and the plus button. That can be used for volume. It also is used to navigate through documents. If you go into the menus, you can use it to move through the menu choices. This button here is called the trigger button. That's normally what you use to take the picture of the document you're wanting to look at. It also lets you accept a thing. If you're in a menu, you can accept, you know, the menu choice or change it with that trigger button. One thing I should tell you that's available here, which I really can't demonstrate, but it's part of what they sell this product for. People who are dyslexic or have a cognitive disability sometimes like things like this. And what this will do, it has a laser pointer in it, and I've got it turned off now, but if it's on, you can actually, if you can see, which is why I don't use it this way, but if you can see, you can point it, for example, to a paragraph on a page and click it, and it'll just read that little spot right there for you. And that is a product, or that is a feature that they've designed for the dyslexic or other people with reading disabilities. So notice it does not require any internet connection, and that again, there's a lady who has a job in a place that doesn't let you use internet. It will connect to your wireless network if you want it to. This one connects to mine at home. The only reason that you do that is if you plug it into an electrical outlet and have it on, it will connect to your network, and all it's doing is watching for software updates. If you unplug it, it'll immediately disconnect from your network. It doesn't send any data, anything you take a picture of doesn't go anywhere. It's just designed to get software updates, and the software updates are free.
This device is specifically aimed at people who want quick and portable OCR. Now, it's a little bit trickier because you have to learn how to point it, and it takes some practice to kind of get the idea. I like to do it this way. I'll hold it out this way, and I'll point it, and I'll see if it works as well as it did this morning.
Champlain, New York, 129194569, phone 800-722, customer ID 018, access, Karl Smith. At 018 New York 1 Champlain, New York 12919.
I can stop it. I can start it again.
Oh, that's it. Humanware. Humanware USA Incorporated 1UPS.
So everything that it does is within itself, and it's pretty quick. You know, it really did a pretty nice job of grabbing that and doing it. Sometimes if you don't get it right, you'll miss part of it. It will oftentimes advise you that there's text that it didn't pick up. It will recognize that there's maybe some text that didn't get picked up. This is nice in a way because you can also do things. I know when we first brought this into Everett, he was pointing it around his office, and it was reading his master's certificate on the wall, and it was reading all kinds of stuff that was hanging up there. You can point this at anything. There is a demo of a guy on the internet, a YouTube video of him outside taking pictures of street signs. He takes a picture of a business across the street from him, and it reads part of the sign so he knows what it is. So it will read any kind of print that it sees. So it's very handy that way. Another feature it has that I really like, which is only on this product, I don't know of anybody else who does it. One of the things that you have when you do OCR, and you noticed it on the other machine and you'll notice it here, If you get it, take a picture of the whole page, it will start reading the page and it'll just keep reading and it'll read the whole page, which may be what you want, but it may not be what you want. Maybe if it's a familiar thing, maybe it's your power bill or maybe it's something you see every month. And all you really want to know is, what do I owe? Because you know the rest of it. You just want to know, how much is it? Well, normally with OCR, you just have to sort of chunk through it, either, you know, arrowing through until you get there or listening to it. There is a feature on this device called smart reading, which I'm going to try. Again, it takes, you know, I have to aim it properly. I'll point it this way. Smart read.
Note that some of the text was unreadable. Ready.
Find humanware.
Found one result of human. Humanware USA Incorporated 1UP Sway PO Box 800 Champlain.
Find SN.
I didn't understand. Let's try again.
Find date.
Found one result of date. Date February 3rd, 2022.
So what the point is here,
I am listening.
Exit.
Exiting.
The point of smart read is that once you get, if you have something you're familiar with, once you take a picture like that, you can have it read things that you know are there. I had it, you find the word humanware, had it find the word date, and read me the date. If there were more than one date on there, it would say found three dates, and it would tell you what they are. And this is something which is, you know, it's not available on any other OCR device because it actually can do, you know, can isolate information for you quickly, which is not normally what you do with OCR. It's small, put it in your pocket, put it around your neck. I suggested they should put a pin, like a pocket clip on it, but they haven't done that. The other thing that that a lot of people like to do, you can take this and read a can, like a soup can. We demonstrated this to a lady who wanted to buy it. Her husband was not excited about it. They're both totally blind. He's like, I don't know. She said, well, he spent his stimulus money his way, I'm spending mine my way. And so he brought in a box and we took a picture of it and it read off that it was a certain kind of popcorn. And by the time we got done trying things, he said, I'm impressed. So, you know, it's something that people, you can use around the house. I have a friend who bought one of these. She lives in Nebraska. She takes it to the store and she said her husband doesn't like it because she finds things. Oh, hey, there's some Chef Boyardee macaroni and cheese. I want some of that. And that she didn't know before. And so now she finds things. So it's, again, a product like this does take some practice to learn how to point it, to kind of get used to what distances work best. I like to hold my material off that way. Some people have different arm lengths and so forth. So you kind of have to work on that. But once you get used to it and get set up with the, you know, exactly how it works, then it gets much easier.
Hi, my name is Everett Bacon. I am the Assistive Technology Specialist here at the Division of Services for the Blind and Low Vision. You just saw a bunch of great products demonstrated by Karl Smith with Access Technology, and he said he would come to your home, and that's a wonderful thing. But if you would like maybe a little bit longer demonstration, maybe you're a vocational rehabilitation client or some other area that you need assistance at, we can definitely show you all of those products that Karl demonstrated today and a whole lot more. And we're here at the Division of Services for the Blind, located in Salt Lake City, Utah. You can reach me at ebacon, E-B-A-C-O-N, at utah.gov, or you can call me at 801-323-4343.
My name is Karl Smith. I am the owner operator of Access Technology, which is an assistive technology company here in Salt Lake City. I have been doing this for 30 years, And I have various types of equipment for people with low vision or people with no vision at all. I sell various kinds of hardware and software. I deal with video magnifiers for people who have low vision, OCR products or optical character products for people who have no vision or prefer to have something read out loud to them. I also deal in Braille products. We have Braille displays, which you can use to read material in Braille with, or connect to your computer or iPhone and run your computer or iPhone with a keyboard and a Braille display so you can see what's written on the screen. I prefer to connect up with people and come out to wherever they are and show them products that they're interested in, because I think especially if we're at your home and you want to see things, I say this way you have everything you want to look at right there. And it's also a good way to find out for sure, if you're particularly if you're looking at a video magnifier, where are you going to put it? Because if you put it in a place, for example, where you're looking straight into a bright window, it may make it difficult for you to read because your eyes are seeing this window. On the other hand, you don't want it the window directly behind you either, because it could also reflect off the screen, and that may make it difficult. And so if we're in your home or workplace, we can see where you would put this and make sure it works the best. So that's what I do. I've been doing it for, like I said, 30 years, and I am available for anybody to have, who has questions or wants to talk to me. I'm happy to do that. You can contact me at 866-824-7885. That's a toll-free number that will connect to whatever phone I happen to have it tied to at the moment. It'll either ring my mobile or my office or wherever. And if I'm not there, you can leave a message and I can call you back. You can also reach me at Karl, K-A-R-L, at AxisTech, which is AXISTECH.net.